strength, and have the Holy Spirit help us all of us in our life. I think whenever we come to church, there's a lot of you who hear scripture at two masses at school, and then you come in here on Sundays, and you know a lot about scripture, probably more than Father DeVos or Father Mayhew. But you listen to this a lot, and I say that because every Sunday when we come together in here, I think it's important just to listen carefully, because a lot of these readings have to do with 1 Corinthians and what happened. And the three readings we have today are just awesome. The first one is from the Acts of the Apostles, and from now to Pentecost, every Sunday and every day, the first reading is from the Acts of the Apostles. That was written by St. Luke, and he recorded the beginning of the church. He told everybody about what happened and what was going on. And I think just to listen to this, because that's the same thing, kids, that happens to us in our faith. Sometimes it's slow, and sometimes it's hard, and it's difficult, but you just have to persevere and continue to believe, and Christ will be there, and he'll come and help. The second reading is from St. Peter, and St. Peter made a great change in his life. It's amazing how he transformed and he changed his life, and I think for all of us, we want to do the same thing. But things aren't going well, and we're having trouble, and things are not the way we hoped they would be. You just have to persevere, keep the faith, and you're going to be okay. God is going to be there. The third reading is this gospel about a man. Have any of you ever had a time in your life where all of a sudden you just want to get away? The things that are going on, I hope I'm not putting things in your mind right now. But I think there are times, you know, some days things don't go well, and you say, oh, I just want to get out of this. This is a mess. And right before Easter, I was out getting groceries at a grocery store, Hy-Vee, right up the street. And this young guy was checking out my groceries, and he looked at me, and I was dressed as a priest, and he said, "Hi, Father, how are you?" And I said, "Good." He said, "What are you doing for Easter?" And I said, "Well, I got a lot of church, and then I'm going to go with my family and have brunch." That's really nice. And I said to him, "What are you going to do?" And he said, "I'm going to go hide." I said, "You're going to go hide?" He said, "Yeah, I'm going to go hide." And I'm going, "Oh boy, this is opening a can of worms here. I got to be careful." And I looked at him and I thought, "Oh, I better not open this up right in the middle of the public and everybody else." But I said, "Well, I'm sorry to hear that." But I said, "I'm praying for you." And he said, "I really appreciate that." He said, "There's a lot of people coming to our house and I just don't get along with them." And so he volunteered this message and he said, "I just want to go hide for the day." And, you know, you listen to that and you say, "Oh man, I feel bad for him. That's a tough way to be." Now, the reason I say that, you just heard a reading from St. Luke about two of the disciples that took off after the resurrection of Jesus. They didn't understand this, and all they wanted to do was get out of there. They saw Jesus suffer, they saw him die, he was crucified, and they didn't understand the resurrection, and all of a sudden they just said, "You know what? I want to get out of here." And so they took off walking to a village called Emmaus. And guess what? They're walking along 7 miles to go to Emmaus. And guess who's walking with them? And they don't recognize them. Who do you think was walking with them? Jesus. He was right there with them. And he starts asking all sorts of questions. And they didn't recognize who he was. And he started telling them about himself bread. And what's that bread when he handed out? What's that a symbol of? You're doing it today. First communion. They had their first communion right there in Lopez's house. And he just broke the bread. And then as soon as he did that, they said, oh my goodness, it's the Lord. He's here. Can you believe this? And just like that, he disappeared. He just vanished from their sight. He did a lot of that after he was raised from the dead. He'd be there, and the next minute you know, he's gone somewhere else. Or you walk into something, and guess who appears? Jesus. Now, the reason I say that is because Jesus, after your first communion, is always going to be there. You may not recognize him, but he is always going to be there, and he's going to be there to help you. In anything you need in your life, all you have to do is say, Jesus, I need your help here. I don't want to run away, and I don't want to go hide. I want you to be with me and help me. And so that's a wonderful gift that Jesus brings to all of us, but especially all of you today. This is an awesome experience when you think about it. For 2,000 years, people have been celebrating what you're doing today, your first communion. And I think for all